When you think about where you're expanding and mapping a broader strategy for the organization, would China be another one of those places where it's obvious that they've been a supply chain, now they're also a market? Could you talk about the potential for China?
China is our third largest market in the world for Dell to sell its products. And you know, we've had 7 years of 45% compounded annual growth in China. So we have two factories in China. We're heading rapidly into the West, into the tier 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 type cities, and penetrating those as well. And there are uniquenesses in every market, and China has a scale that is unparalleled, but we're going after it. And you can find just about every principal activity of Dell occurring in China, from IT development to research and development to manufacturing to sales, service, support. I mean, you pretty much have all aspects of the company operating there.
How would you advise entrepreneurs who want to break into that market and think about it both from, as you say, the back office or the development side, as well as a consumer market?
We find some differences there, but when you talk about the way larger organizations work, whether they're global companies or the large Chinese national companies, it's not dramatically different from the way large companies work in other countries in the world. When you get in the consumer market, that could be a bit different because of credit and the scale and distribution, those kinds of things. And of course, you have many different Chinas. I mean, you have the cities, you have the rural, you have all these tier 3 through 7 cities. So there's a multitude of opportunities. But one thing that we found in China is customers really value relationship. And so, when Dell comes and says we want to have a relationship, and we show up and we stay, and we want to understand more about their business and more about their needs, that works. I mean, it actually works everywhere. I think it's a universal kind of belief system that people want to have relationships.
Right. It's a ubiquitous principle of all cultures, and certainly there, I think, understanding that there's so many differences between the different Chinas is a bit like understanding, I think, all the different markets that you have around the world within the U.S. and Europe. Is there a description you can make of a particular visit that had impact on you when you realized things had changed in terms of serving China?
We've had to do things differently there to achieve the success when we first started in China, first of all, it's not for the faint of heart, because there's a lot of things that are sort of changing and unpredictable. I remember at one point we had this was very early on in our China experience. We built this brand new factory, and a bunch of guys showed up from some government agency, and they had a bunch of papers, and they said, "Oh well, you can't build computers from this factory anymore." It says here on this paper. This is what we were kind of told as a translation. And so we said, "Hold on a second, what do you mean?" And so we kind of called the mayor over, and then these guys are fighting and arguing, and then 2 hours later, it's all solved, not a problem anymore. But that was the kind of thing that was happening quite a bit in China, just an unpredictable, almost chaotic environment where you had to sort of be ready for anything, because it was evolving so quickly, they were kind of making up the rules as they went along.